I'm a pugilist specialist, so to box Deontay would be a great fight for me because he's one-dimensional. I'd rather fight him than Tyson Fury because Tyson Fury gives you all kinds of different looks, and he would have to get me thinking a little bit more. So Deontay, I would probably go towards and try and hit him to the body because he would be taller than me, and I would think I would be a more of an effective body puncher against him.
I think one thing too we gotta give Deontay Wilder credit for. We understand what his gift is, his God-given gift, his power. And it's in his right hand. I know he still has a left hand, but we know him for his right hand. But it's also the skill, the nuance that he's developed over time to set that right hand up. He's learned how to get guys in the right position at the right time and land the shot in the right spot in order to get them out of there. That's skill. This is a guy who doesn't have 35 amateur fights, went on to win a bronze medal, was the only medalist in that Olympics, and he's obviously had a small sample size as an amateur, so he's learning on the job. That's why he had a lot of guys, he fought a lot of what we call dead men in the sport of boxing early on, trying to understand who he was as a professional fighter. He's done that. His style is established. He is improving little by little, but we got to give him credit for the skill that he does display.
Not at all.
You can indeed.
Most of the time we say it's the punch that you don't see is the one that hurts you. You can see a Deontay Wilder's punch coming and it hits you on the chin and it's lights out. You can see it coming. That's what makes him special. That's what makes him special as well.